Hello, welcome to Deceptology at State Library Victoria. My name is Nicholas J. Johnson. Before we begin, I would just like to acknowledge the traditional owners of the land that we're on today, as well as their elders, past and present. We have some amazing magic and science for you today, drawn from the W.G. Alma Conjuring Collection, a huge collection of magic books here at State Library Victoria. Some of them you can only access here on site, but there's a huge amount available on the State Library website. Today we're going to look at some magic and also the science behind the magic. It's going to be a lot of fun. One of my favorite tricks in the world is sawing a lady in half. Now, unfortunately, we don't have a giant box or a person or even a saw in order to do that trick today. So we're going to do the next best thing. So instead of a box, I'm going to use this handkerchief. Instead of a saw, I'm going to use these pieces of rope here. I've got a couple of pieces of rope. So that's two saws for the price of one. And instead of a lady, I'm going to use this lamp. So the first thing I'm going to do is, since this doesn't really work if I put the handkerchief around here, so I might just tie that here around the center of our two pieces of rope. You're going to be able to try this yourself at home when we're done. If you want to, you can do it with shoelaces, you can do it with string, or you can get some professional grade magician's rope like I've got my hands on. Great. So there we have our two boxes. You know what, let's make it a little bit fancier. One, because it looks pretty, and two, because I like showing off my massive collection of pocket squares that I have. I'm going to tie a couple more on here just to make sure that they are all together. There we go. There's a shiny one as well. Great. So we've got our rope and we've got our pocket squares. Slide those into the middle like that. Now, what we need to do is to see if we can just loop this here around the lamp. Now, if I pull very, very hard right now, either the rope will break or the lamp will break. Either way, they're not having me back at the State Library. I'm going to make it even easier though. Check this out. Watch. Harder, I should say, because I'm going to take these two pieces of rope and tie a knot like that in the middle. So now, there's absolutely no possible way that that rope can get through that lamp. Are you ready? Here we go. 3, 2, 1. Whoa. And look at that. It's not only passed right through the lamp, it's also passed through all three of the pocket squares, and no one has been harmed. So how is this possible? Well, this trick relies on something called Gestalt psychology. And Gestalt psychology is the psychology of patterns. You see, the human brain loves patterns. We love recognizing patterns and we love making up patterns even if that pattern isn't there. For example, there is what is called the law of There is the law of proximity. So if you have a look at these three circles, they look like three circles, but there's no reason why they have to be three circles. They could be one circle and three kind of weird crescenty moon shapes. But because they were near to each other, your brain completed the pattern and told you that they were three circles. There's also the law of completion. Can you see the black triangle that's right there in the middle of the screen? Well, if you look closer, you'll see there is no black triangle. There's actually just three circles with a little wedge taken out of the middle of them. However, your brain likes to complete patterns, and so it completes the missing shapes into the shape of a triangle. So, what law do we use for this trick here? Well, the law that we're using for this trick is called the law of continuation. And that is the idea that the human brain likes to continue patterns. So, for example, your brain sees a line going this way. It doesn't expect it to go off in strange, weird directions. It expects it to continue in the same way as it did before. So if I take this piece of rope here, or both of them I should say, and hold them out like this and say, I have here two pieces of rope, your brain will tell you that there are two straight pieces of rope. But there isn't. Have a look at this. It's actually two pieces of rope that have been folded in half. So in order to do this trick, you're going to get two pieces of rope, and then you're going to get a little piece of thread and tie it around the middle there, just like that, so that they hold together. And you're going to keep that hidden in your hand. You then get a handkerchief or a serviette, anything at all that you can tie around the middle, even a big bead, like a big sort of chunky bead, and you cover that sneaky bit in the middle with your handkerchief and then tie it on. I'm going to do kind of a messy job now because we're not trying to hide anything. So you can see that that really does look like two straight pieces of rope. Now if I put this here around our precious lamp like this, now if I pulled right now, the trick wouldn't work. What I need to do is to take two pieces and tie a knot in them, just like that. Yeah? So now when I pull, what I'm trying to do is actually break that little piece of thread that's holding everything together at the back. And when that breaks, everything travels around the lamp and not through it. So I'll do it as slowly as I can, and you could see it just traveling straight through, just like that. Now, what is brilliant about this principle, Gestalt psychology, is that it is used all the time by magicians. Pretty much any rope trick you use, that you see, relies on Gestalt psychology. Sawing a lady in half relies on Gestalt psychology. So the more you learn about that particular way of thinking, the more you're gonna learn about magic. Now I've gotta figure out which one of these pocket squares suits me the best. See you later.